Hello and happy Sunday to all of you all. I hope you all are doing great, and so am I. 26th July, Kargil Memorial Day, which is going to be tomorrow. What a state. We are only going to go or maybe walk through the memory lane of what we have achieved and what we have lost. In terms of land, in terms of supremacy, in terms of brutality, I think if it is compared, then it is more brutal to lose people. Kargil war is a war which India has won, but at the cost of people. Can there be a better version of our humankind existing either side of the border? क्या हम वो भाईचारा ला सकते हैं? क्या हम ये समझ सकते हैं कि हम अपनी सीमा में जो कर सकते हैं बेहतर, चाहे फिर वो हमारी सुख समृद्धि हो, सुख और चैन हो, अमन हो, हमारी समृद्धि हो, हम आगे बढ़ रहे हैं एक विकास का एक आयाम लेकर, ऐसा कुछ हम सोच के कर सकते हैं? काश ऐसा कर सकते हैं, क्योंकि कल का दिन अगर 26 जुलाई है और कारगिल मेमोरियल डे कहलाता है, तो मेरी श्रद्धांजलि उन सभी को जो बॉर्डर के इस तरफ हमारे हिंदुस्तान के मारे गए हैं, और उस तरफ भी जो शायद बचाए जा सकते थे, शायद टाला जा सकता था। काश ऐसा होता। और इतिहास में हम मेमोरियल डे वॉर को लेके नहीं मनाते। शिक्षा जो फिनलैंड देता है, चाहे फिर वो इजराइल देता है अपने सैनिकों को, वो हम शायद सिखाते हैं। हर एक जो हमारे सिटीजन है उनको शायद ये शिक्षा देते और सबको एक अंदर वॉरियर बनाते, जैसे कि पेंडेमिक टाइम पे हुआ है। 28 जुलाई एज वर्ल्ड हेपेटाइटिस डे। मैं हाल ही में एक डॉक्टर से मिलने गया था, और उस डॉक्टर से बातों में मालूम पड़ा कि वो कितने चिंतित है हेपेटाइटिस को, जिसे सफ़ेद पीलिया कहा जाता है। वो सफ़ेद पीलिया एक्चुअली बहुत घातक है। वो कहते हैं कि जिस तरह से HIV होता है और जिस तरह से उसकी ट्रीटमेंट ली जाती है, आपकी इम्यून सिस्टम बेकार हो जाती है। आप आने वाले पीढ़ी को जो जन्म दोगे, अगर दो व्यक्ति एक साथ मिलते हैं और उनमें से किसी को एक सफ़ेद पीलिया होता है, तो शायद आने वाली पीढ़ी को भी वही होगा। यानी कितना मुश्किल है ये बात समझना जब तक हम इसका ब्लड टेस्ट ना करें। और दैट्स द रीजन ही हैज बीन हेल्पेड टू आस्क पीपल अपील दैट गो फॉर अ ब्लड टेस्ट इंस्टेड ऑफ कुंडली मैच दैट वी नॉर्मली डू। यू माइट एज वेल डू इट। आई एम नॉट सेइंग इट्स अ रिप्लेसमेंट, बट इफ यू कैन पॉसिबली डू द ब्लड टेस्ट एंड रूल आउट दैट यू हैव एनी काइंड ऑफ अ सिकल सेल एनीमिया, यू हैव हेपेटाइटिस, दैट काइंड ऑफ एन हेपेटाइटिस दैट वी आर टॉकिंग अबाउट, और इफ यू हैव एनीथिंग दैट कैन बी ट्रांसमिटेड थ्रू ब्लड और through the genetics to the offspring, I think we are not talking of healthy India here. If we want healthy India, the prosperity is something that is going to come. Well, 28th is also a World Nature Conservation Day. Sundarlal Bahuguna, who passed just a month and a half. Medha Patkar, who's living with us. Dr. Amte, I think the senior Dr. Amte has already left us. We have only all the good things that has been taught by Dr. Amte to their offspring is being still practiced. Mrs. Menaka Gandhi. Why I am naming this, they have something in common. And what is that? They are either environmentalist, they are nature lover, animal lover, and most importantly, they believe in symbiosis. On this 28th of July, World Nature Conservative Day, I have an appeal. It is said that we are going to live for next 100 years. Yes, what I'm saying is what I have heard it from an IIT professor. He says that the kind of living that we are doing now, 100 years, is something that will last and not beyond. Now, it took 1 million years, 10 lakh years, to bring the levels of carbon dioxide to 200, and for last 100 years, we have doubled it. It has crossed 420 carbon dioxide, and which is amounting to only pollution. Now, there has been practically no rains in South Africa. There has been practically no rains in many parts of the countries. Himalayas glaciers are melting down, and now you can see the thin Himalaya. In fact, what it was to, you know, a decade or a couple of decades before, it is now coming down. Rajasthan in India is touching 50 to 54 degrees. Latur, Marathwada, Maharashtra. You can find 50 to 100 acres and beyond acreages, farmers, they are leaving their homes, you know, putting a lock in their houses and leaving their homes, their towns, just in search of a job where they can meet their, you know, expenses, meet two ends. How difficult it is, how alarming it is. Now, other than this, there is also the silver dioxide effect. Now, what is this? To get the artificial rains, our silver dioxides are spread on the clouds, and because of it, you have artificial rains. Maharashtra government in particular has sanctioned 30 crores for artificial rains. Maybe very specific to Marathwada, because if we are not taking care of our nature there and do the farming, the basic farming, the basic occupation of India, perhaps we are going away from the nature. Despite you still have silver iodized rains, artificial rains working for you, but it's not the natural process. There is a better way out there. Ocean levels has risen to 350, and it will happen. If it does not, it will definitely happen. Couple of years we have seen Kerala, how the floods were, and the rehabilitation has not yet seen the light of the day. What about these oceans surrounding India and the various parts of the countries? If they rise to 300 feet level, then I think all the coastal cities and countries will vanish. Just overnight, they will not be there in the map. It is not about me, it is not about you, it is about us, because it is not to do with government what they are going to do. If you think that you need to change, you want a change, if you want a shade for your car to be parked, I think you need to plant trees. If you want that, you want to really see the natural water, then essentially you need to have the STPs in process so that there are enough water for watering the plants and maybe put some greenery. If you want drinking water, rain water harvesting has been talked about endlessly for so many years. I think time to practice. It's also very important to conserve our mother nature by planting more trees. You know, India and China were the biggest contributor in the last 2 years, where NASA flashed a picture that Earth has gone more greener. But it is only because of that 2 years that are passing by, because of the inactivity, because of the controlling pollution, and it's only because of this pandemic. Nothing that we have done magical, nothing that we have done intentional. So it's time to also look at our aviation industry. Sweden has almost surcharged their tariffs, but Finland is a country which I have already taken name of, exemplary country. They have asked their people not to travel by aviation. Why? Because carbon emissions are on rise. CFCs with lot of emission, and it is taking a toll on the clouds, and that's the reason you have hazardous rays, you know, coming to you, and your skin is getting some or the other kind of new diseases. Let me also put that very straight, that nuclear emissions are also a great dent. Now, many of the good countries, the developed countries, US, Germany, and so on, they have realized the importance of globe, and that's the reason the global warming needs to be arrested. That's the reason there is a long-term effect of no factories, no productions, no yields of farmer or occupation of that sort is going to be seen, because the 30 years is a practical time where you have seen Nagasaki or Hiroshima not doing anything. But Japan, whenever there is an AC, you know, brought in the house, they ensure that it is not going below 28 degrees. So if Japan's, Finland and bigger countries can do, I think we need to just emulate. Every second house is suffering from cancer. If not now, then all the towers that you are using your mobiles from, I think that will be the biggest reason, as the latest survey and research finds it out. When video conferencing can be a better option, why to go personally and spend those money from the people's pocket? I'm talking about these politicians. If you can think of a better option, I think there is always a way out to safeguard our Mother Earth. It's the World Conservative Day, Nature Conservative Day, and we need to conserve it. We need to protect it. Let there be more education in the society. It's not about education, it's about literacy, where 52% of the women, if they are found malnourished, then we will not have the healthy brains and healthy minds working for us. My only request is, if we can decide to go green, this is the time. Otherwise, it's a fallacy. 29 July is International Tiger Day. Tiger is one classical example of making others believe that life isn't easy. It takes vigilance, it takes awareness, it takes power, it takes stamina and staying power put together to survive from the clutches of tigers. That's what all the animals do. And I'm alarming and putting it all together, because Hepatitis Day will be observed. So will be Kargil Memorial Day. So will be the World Nature Conservative Day and the Tigers Day. What we all need to infer is, can we do enough for them? Can we live in symbiosis? If that is the thought and that is what the concern that I want to raise in for all of you, उम्मीद करता हूँ कि मेरे इस concern को शायद आप कहीं ना कहीं अपने जीवन में बदलाव के रूप में लाएंगे, और लाएंगे तो इस मानव जाति का ही सबसे बड़ा भला होगा, और ऐसा करना अभी अनिवार्य है, अभी नहीं तो फिर कभी नहीं। सोचिएगा।